Today I am starting the first chapter of class 9th, that is the revision video, and we are starting the first unit, number system. And the chapter first is real number, that is a revision video, and we are taking some important questions as well as revision of the concepts. So students, so we are starting the chapter real numbers. So in the chapter real numbers, in the previous videos I told you about the natural numbers and then whole numbers and then integers and then rational numbers and then irrational numbers and then real numbers. So these type of numbers we studied in the previous videos. Now we will study about the questions, basic or important questions for the examination purpose, for your UD1 examination purpose. So students, all of you see, I am taking some questions from the different exercises as an important question. And you know students, this exam will be online or it is like fill in the blanks, true false, MCQs and long answer questions, one word question, one line questions and long questions also. So you have to prepare yourself. So see all of you. Let us, I am taking exercise 1.1. In exercise 1.1 you can see some important questions, like I have one question from that exercise. Find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Means in this question I have to find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Yes students, I have written that question in very short format. So the question is 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Yes students, we have to find that 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. 3 and 4 are two integers and we can assume that these are the rational numbers also. So students, the solution is here. Here the numbers are 3 and 4. Here the numbers are 3 and 4. The numbers are 3 and 4. 3 can be written as 3 upon 1 and 4 can be written as 4 upon 1. We are finding the 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. So first of all, for finding out the rational numbers, first we clear that the denominator should be equal. The denominator should be equal, like 3 upon 1 and 4 upon 1. First step is equal the denominators. So we can see that 3 upon 1 and 4 upon 1 denominators are already equal. Now we are finding the 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. So we will multiply by 7 on both sides in numerator and denominator. So students, here again we will not write here. N is equal to, the value of N is 6. So N plus 1 is equal to 7. N की value 6 है, N plus 1 की value 7 है. Now 3 upon 1 into 7 into 7 and 4 upon 1 into 7 into 7. 7 3 is 21, 7 into 7 and 7 4 is 28 and 7 into 7. So students, you can see that in between the numbers are 21 upon 7 and 28 upon 7. In 21 upon 7 and 28 upon 7, you can easily find out the 6 rational numbers. So you can write here that the 6 rational numbers are 21 upon 22 upon 7, 23 upon 7, 24 upon 7, 25 upon 7, 26 upon 7 and 27 upon 7 and the last one is 28 upon 7. So students, you can observe that the numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can say that there are 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. The numbers are 22 upon 7, 23 upon 7, 24 upon 7 and the last one is 27 upon 7. After it all, we will start the next questions. students, you can see all of you. You can observe that also. Yes, students. Again, that I am taking another question. That is, I am taking a very important question. That is most important question. I am taking it first because if I have left it, then it will be left. Okay. And question number 4 is 4 of, that is very important question from the exercise 1.3. Represent root 9.3 on the number line. The question is represent root 9.3 on the number line. So students, see all of you, represent root 9.3 on the number line. Means in this question we have to represent root 9.3 on the number line. So students, you can see the solution of it. First of all, here it is. First of all, we will draw 9.3. First of all, we will draw a line of 9.3. Like it is A and it is B. AB line is of 9.3 centimeter. Okay, students, there is no problem. You have to draw a line of 9.3 centimeter first. Now, we will add 1 centimeter in the 9.3. Now, we will add 1 centimeter in 9.3, like this. Means from this point to this point, we will add 1 centimeter. That is point C. Now, the line is A, B, and C. After it all, we will draw a line bisector of AC, not of AB. We will draw the line bisector of AC. So, AC is the line, and we will draw, we will take the radius more than half, like this. This one and this one and that one and that one, and we will join these lines like this. After it all, let this point is O. The point is O. Now OA and OC will be equal because that is a line bisector. A line bisector is a line that bisects the required line. So OA is equal to OC. Let I am taking a semicircle with the radius OA and center O. After taking O as the center and OA as the radius, the semicircle will be like this. Okay, students, the semicircle will be like this. OA and OC. Semicircle will be as the radius of the radius. Achha, humara semicircle bana gaya. After the semicircle, we will draw a line from B perpendicular to it like this. Means we will draw a line from B. That is not a B. Sorry. That is not a B. That is a B. We will draw, let assume that we are drawing, we left a rocket from the B. B se rocket chhod diya humne. So rocket is always like this. So that is the point. That it is, that point is D. So B se rocket chhoda ho. सेमीसर्कल को डी पे आगे देता है, दैट इज डी. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, लेट बी एज अ सेंटर एंड बी डी एज अ रेडियस लाइक दिस. वी विल जर्न एंड ड्रॉ अ लाइन लाइक दिस एंड वी विल मूव फॉरवर्ड इट लाइक दिस. दैट बी सी, दैट बी सी एंड दैट इज डी एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज डी डैश. That is D and that is called as D dash, and that B D dash, that B D dash is the representation of root 9.3 on the number line. That is the representation of root 9.3, that B D dash. So you can say that B D dash is equal to root 9.3 is the on the number line. Okay students, I hope you understood it very well. We have represented root 9.3 on the number line, and we are having a question like this in the example section also. Represent root 4.5 on the number line. That is also like this. So students, you can see here also again, I am taking many more questions from like this. Yes. Yes, now again I am starting the another questions. Let I am taking the example number 2, that is same as other questions also. Locate root 2 on the number line, means we have to locate root 2 on the number line. For locating root 2 on the number line, that is the root 3 also and root 5 also in the exercise questions. So if you understood that question, then you will definitely understood that question also. So we have to represent root 2 on the number line. So students, first of all I will draw a number line like this. Number line is like this, that is 0, that is 1, that is 2, that is minus 1 and that is minus 2. We are representing root 2 on the number line. So first of all, we are having 0 to 1, that is 1 unit. O से लेके E तक की डिस्टेंस माना कि 1 यूनिट है. अब मान लिया कि यहां से बेटा इस पे A पे 1 यूनिट परपेंडिकुलर भी है. 1 यूनिट A पे परपेंडिकुलर है एंड दैट पॉइंट इज B. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एंड दैट पॉइंट इज B, लेट वी विल जॉइन दिस फ्रॉम O टू B. सबसे पहले लेट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द सॉल्यूशन हियर. ओ ए इज इक्वल टू 1 यूनिट, ए बी इज इक्वल टू 1 यूनिट एंड वी हैव टू रिप्रेजेंट रूट 2 ऑन द नंबर लाइन. सो स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन सी इन ट्रायंगल ए ओ बी, यू आर वाचिंग द ट्रायंगल ए ओ बी. इन ट्रायंगल ए ओ बी, ओ बी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू OB square plus AB square, that is by Pythagoras theorem. That is because of Pythagoras theorem. OB square, OA that is 1 square plus AB that is also 1 square. 1 square is 1, 1 square is 1. So OB square is equal to 1 plus 1, that is 2. OB square is equal to 2. We will take square root on both sides. On taking square root, we have taken the square root of OB square and we will take the square root of 2. Square root square root cancel and that OB is equal to root 2. Means OB is equal to root 2. OB की value आ गई बेटा root 2. ये root 2 है. लेकिन हमें root 2 represent करना है number line. So how can we represent root 2 on the number line? From O to B, we will draw, that is O is the center and OB is the radius and we will join a line like this. That is B and that is B dash. And that OB dash is the representation of root 2 on the number line. So OB is equal to OB dash is equal to root 2 is the representation on the number line. So students, that is the representation of root 2 on the number line. Some questions are similar like this. Representation of root 3 on the number line and representation of root 5 on the number line. Some questions are like this. Let I am taking some more questions also. Yes, see all of you. HCL of your students. Here, let us see exercise 1.3. Question number third, first part. We have to represent 0.65 bar in the form of P upon Q. I have written the question in a very short way. We have to show that 0.6 bar in the form of P upon Q. So for these type of questions, students, I am taking as a short. Let x is equal to 0.6666, and that is the first equation. Because 0.6 bar can be written as 0.6666 like this. How many numbers are repeating here? You can see that one digit is repeating here. So one digit say 101 number hota hai 10. So we will multiply. We will write on multiplying by 10. We get 10 into x is equal to 6.666, and that is the second equation. So that is x, that is written as 0.666, that is 10x, that is written as 6.666. On subtracting first from second, we get second is 10x minus x, that is 6.666 minus 0.666. So students, you can see 10x minus x, that is 9x, and 6.6 minus 0.6, that is 6. So x is equal to 6 upon 9, that is 3 to the 6, 3 to the 9. So x is equal to 4 upon 3. Okay students, that x is equal to 2 upon 3. Okay students, now the class is over for today, and do some important questions also.